Tush, tush, tush.
With haste.
And the gnoll gnawed her arm clean off. So much for the flaming fist, eh? You ain't here. We sacked Joaquin's rest and left it to burn. Drow flinging magic. Gnoll snapping off heads. Inn's nothing but a pile of ash by now. Glorious. Bunch of prisoners got towed to Moonrise. City snobs mostly. But the flaming fist, pile of smoking corpses. You ain't know the broken road? Meh. I'll tell you real slow like, so you don't miss it. North.
Blessed baby!
Tribe? Tribe! Tribe! Looking at a future true soul you are. Boss Ragslin says I'm next in line.
Boss Ragslin, eh? Must be the goblin in charge.
Recognize the overwhelming authority that you've used on others, only infinitely stronger. Your vision clouds, leaving you in a dark, featureless shadowscape. Nothingness in every direction. Then, there are three figures before you. An armored male elf, exuding power and command. A handsome younger man with a quick, easy smile. And a pale young woman. With even paler eyes.
These are my chosen. They speak for me. Aid their search for the weapon, and you will be worthy to stand beside them in my presence.
The visions fade and the voice falters as a strange energy swells around you. The many-sided artifact. Somehow you understand it's repelling the presence.
My power grows. My forces gather. The reckoning draws near.
The voice is quelled. The artifact's doing.
Whatever power the artifact possesses, it shows no sign of it now.
Yeah.
Give up now. Looking ahead.
Thank you.
sounds like they've captured themselves a bath.
Recoil of your bastard!
You look like you've got something jingling in your pocket. Looking to spend it? Nicked him off the dead, didn't I? Get moving. I've got other customers.
Your Raxlin's
snake
is a blade in the quarry.
Oh, the stranger in a fair camp.
Or be you beheaded. Goblin kind will tease you and throat you and redded.
Hells, that yowling bleeds the ears. Bloody human. No offense, mind, just that ain't entertainment. Don't need two mates. We already got the greatest art there is, and it ain't no warbling. It's chicken chasing. It's got feathers, don't it? A beak. Besides, I reckon it owes us, seeing as how it just ate our last chicken. Reckon it owes us a game. You want to hear the rules or not? Only the greatest game since eggs sprouted legs, mate. You just gotta chase the chicken round the course and through the posts. But that ain't all. Gotta do it quick and alone. Any of your mates step in, you lose. Time runs out, you lose. Sound easy? It ain't. Come back when that halfwit's done wailing and find out.
It's got wings.
No.
Bloody bard. Used to be goblins had taste. Bloody bard. Used to be goblins had taste.
Best make is a blade in the quarry. With fragulous crown and with scepter abraid, draw Raxlin, short work of the innkeeper made. The inn burnt to ash. The captives were many. Goblin kind had reduced them to cowering filfenny. So raise it, your goblets, and drain them with pride. Draw Raxlin, the true soul, had let you gallant.
I reckon Draw Raxlin's the gobbo in charge, the way this one's carrying on.
You! Move on!
Do as she says. Now. Now, where was I?
Wait a tick. That a friend of yours?
Certainly not. What are you doing? I'm busy here.
You lying.
To you? Never. Come, let's continue our ballad. Draw Raxlin, draw Raxlin. I am draw Raxlin. Tumptuous, draw Raxlin.
You broke him.
Wait, wait. Draw Raxlin. We pray. We.
Come on, pigeon. Back to your cage.
Now look what you've done.
Come on!
Of course, ma'am.
My name's Gribbo, idiot!
Bloody arm is killing me. Here's to the best sedative there is, booze!
I'm still just a babe. It don't feel right messing with it, is all.
Oh, shut it! What kind of...
How are we to find the druid in this chaos?
No, go inside. Inside. Boring.
Let's see.
Bloody racket.
Oh, come on now. They're just having a bit of fun.
Oi! Ain't no party in here. We're doing the Absolute's work. State your business. Now.
As the symbol glows, power courses through you. Authority.
can't be here to see the true souls. Those types don't even bother to wait.
A shiver runs your mind. You feel sated.
Oh, beg pardon. You must be here to join the other true souls. Please, go right ahead. Well, because that's what you are, innit? One of them as hears our thoughts, and the voice of the Absolute. Like Priestess Gut and Boss Ragslin. Gods, we even got a drow now. The Absolute is gathering us all together for something big, I reckon. Bloody racket.
Oh, come on now. They're just having a bit of fun.
Aye, so much fun that those thieves almost got past.
We got them. Before the world starts singing, we'll know who sent them.
Aye.
Smells like
inside you. I only hear her through you, Priestess.
That's because she chose me. Now, here's somebody special. The Absolute has touched you, hasn't she? Priestess Gut needs to touch you, too. Hold out your arm so I can mark your flesh.
A priestess. One of the leaders, no doubt about it. Let's make her squeal.
What's that? Tell your friend to keep quiet, or he'll lose his good eye. You think you can hurt me? This'll be good. Lads, rip him apart!
Just what to do.
Time to strike.
Battle favors the fearless.
Is weaker for it.
Tempers are rising. It's clear not everything you find is at your disposal.
Your turn if you want to get the mark.
You're being arrested for assault. Judging by the look on this guard's face, you're getting off lightly. It may have been unwise to reveal just how much gold you have on your person.
A good moment to talk.
That the jingle of coin I hear? You've timed it well, my friend. Already turned quite the profit today, so I'm feeling generous.
You recognize the crest she bears, the winged serpent of the Zentarim.
Half right, Sharp Eyes. A Zen is a normal trader. Just a matter of what's for sale. Weapons and other exotic goods, true enough. But most of all, we offer discretion. No judgment, no right and wrong, just good deals and bad. That a problem for you? You joking? Goblins sell the best prisoners. Cheap, quiet, and eager to be elsewhere. Till this crowd converted and started sending their captives to Moonrise Towers, at least. No complaints, mate. I just sold enough smoke powder to cover the loss 10 times over. Ask the drow they're all bowing to. That glint in her eye is bad news for someone. Not my concern, so long as I'm paid. Speaking of, something to trade or what?
You've set foot in a restricted area. A swift exit may be in order.
Ah, glad you've a moment for me. My, predicament has become rather urgent. I need a magical artifact to consume. Right now. We've already found enough magic to soothe its disquiet. If you'll just give me what I need. Glad to see you're so well stocked on suitable relics, but I only need one.
Thank you.
Magic, it's like a lullaby that sings to sleep the demon inside. A metaphorical demon, I haste to point out, but no less dangerous. And no less bound to wake up again to continue its ravages. Such is the nature of all monsters.
Oh, it's not so bad once you get used to it. And, on the plus side, my tower in Waterdeep has never been so free of clutter.
Sincerely, though, I understand I ask a lot from you with few answers in return. But in time, all will be told.
My lord, I bow to your boundless kindness.
Something the matter? Wait. It hurts. A joyous little affliction that visits me with screaming agony on occasion. I'd be lying if I told you I know what causes it. But don't worry. Can't hurt you. Only me. The wound on my hand. It never quite heals. And sometimes it causes terrible pain to rip through me. It's my burden, though, from Lady Shah. I can feel her influence somehow. I cannot say. Not with what I can recall. But even then, it would not be for me to question her will. Lady Shah has her reasons. It's difficult to say. Sometimes I wonder if it's supposed to be guiding me, punishing me, testing me. But perhaps it's none of those. Perhaps it's completely random. I'd like to hope there's more to it than that. Some meaning that Lady Shah will reveal to me when the time is right. Until then, all I can do is endure. It's less difficult than you might imagine when you can't remember life without it. Pain is sacred to followers of Lady Shah. Pain will give way to loss and then to the peace of her eternal darkness. You can tolerate a great deal of suffering so long as it has meaning. I know. I felt it. Yes. No. I don't know. The artifact seems to have powers and a will of its own. It protects us. I don't know how or why, but I'm glad. I felt it go from me to you. You need its help, just as it needs us. Still just a box, after all. Might not be possible. It's stubborn that way, prone to lashing out. Keep it for now. We can all help to protect it.
Gale slurped that thing up like a horse with a carrot. I hope he got what he needed from it.
I've known people who are hungry for power, but Gale takes it a bit too literally for my liking. I wonder how he does it. Why he does it. I'm sure all will be revealed in time, but I don't like it. A waste of perfectly good treasure.
Moisture drips down your forehead. Pain shoots through your fingers. The world swims as you close, then reopen your eyes. How long have you been waiting here? A moment? A night? A 10 day?
Chukilgape vlaketh mazathok. Can you feel it crawling through you? Tendrils squirming in your chest, gripping your heart, piercing your belly. Your bones popping, your flesh swelling. I can. I see it in you. I feel it in me. We are lost. I will be quick with my blade. First you, then the others. Then, myself.
Your minds intertwine. You sense a touch of uncertainty, a touch of disgust. Something stirs deep within you, hungry and alert. It's taking something you'll never get back. Lozelle's fear grips you. Not fear of death, but fear of insignificance. The great warrior Lozelle, a failure to her kind. She will wield no silver sword, ride no red dragon. Forever unknown to the great Lich Queen Vlaketh.
I cannot trust my own mind. So it seems I must trust yours. I will wait. But know this. I am watching. If the sickness does not pass come dawn, I will end us all. I came just in time. You are transforming. Yes, you have. I saved you before. And I'm here to save you again. Don't worry. You will not become a Mind Flayer. Not while I'm around. I'll protect you. We haven't much time, so listen closely. There is great potential within you. It comes from that parasite. Your instinct is to resist the power it gives, but you must accept it. Nurture it. I will keep it from consuming you, but for the sake of both of us, you must learn to wield it. Fate of Faerun, a fight we are losing. For now. You can change that, but only if you embrace your potential. I have to go. The enemy is closing in. I will be back.
Ahead.
My apologies. Not quite myself just yet. I had the strangest dream last night. A visitor came to me. A vision of unparalleled beauty and power. She told me she was watching over me, protecting me. And that our tadpoles could prove beneficial if we embrace what powers they have to offer. An uncanny apparition. Not entirely sure what to make of it. Very curious. In all my readings on the effects of illithid parasites, I've never come across any accounts of correlating dreams between infected parties. Another unique quality of our predicament, perhaps. Are you inclined to take these visitors at their word? Nothing wrong with maintaining a healthy suspicion in such matters. Still, it might be wiser to keep an open mind on the matter. Our visitors' promises of aid might yet bear valuable fruit.